Our seniors are serving at the soup kitchen. Is that today? Is that why they're not all here? Okay. I was wondering. It's like, man, we got some holes here today. So they're serving at the soup kitchen today. So we want to pray for them, that God would touch them and help them as they're ministering to those this morning. If you've not gotten any stuff to help with the flood relief in Lumberton, if you've not been able to bring anything, see Beth this morning. If you could slide her $5, $10 or something like that, I'm sure she could probably make a run to a dollar store somewhere and load up some stuff and give it. She's sitting over there. If y'all want to grab your wallet, she'll take it right now in the name of Jesus. Amen. So anyway, if you can help with that, I'm sure that will be a blessing. And don't forget about kids' worship time after this worship this morning. And in our service tonight at 6. So we encourage you to come out tonight for our service. And then our youth are going to a service tonight with Eddie and his crew. They're going to be in Gastonia tonight at 6 o'clock. So please keep that in mind. If you got any questions about that, you can see Tabitha or Stephanie. Then we got prayer meeting tomorrow at 6. So, and then, of course, our Bible study on Tuesday night. I think I got ahead of her. All right, all our classes. So let's stand, and we're going to go to the Lord in prayer. No, we're not. We're going to see the Lord in prayer. Amen. I got it backwards today, but that's all right. If you're not able to be back with us in the services this week, I hope you have a wonderful Thanksgiving. Remember why we're doing what we're doing. Don't wait for Thursday to start giving thanks, but give thanks every day. Amen. Amen. For the Lord is great and greatly to be praised. Amen. So if you're traveling this week, please be careful, and we look forward to having you back when you get here. Don't forget about the Tanglewood trip. That is this coming Saturday. Yeah, this coming Saturday, 4 o'clock. $5 for food or extra money for the gift shop. If you got any questions about that, you can see Beth, and she'll be able to tell you more about that for the kids' trip this coming Saturday to Tanglewood. That's always a great little trip. They go see the Christmas lights and got some things that's going on. So also, Sister Sheila is collecting for the nursing home, for the class, personal hygiene products, things of that nature. If you got any questions about that, see Sister Sheila, and she'll be able to tell you more about that. When are you taking that? December 19th. So you got a couple of weeks. If it's not something that you want to shop for, same deal. You can slip her a little bit of money, and she'll be able to go and get the things that's needed for those attendants at the nursing home. Listen, the nursing home she goes to, there's a lot of attendants there that families don't even have anything to do with, and they just kind of put them there. So sometimes when our kids go there and Sister Sheila goes there, that's the only attention that those folks get, and they crave it. So this is definitely an outreach. So please keep that in mind. The youth will be having their Christmas party a week from this Saturday. So please keep that in mind. If you got any questions about that, see Steph or Tabitha, and they'll be able to tell you more about that. All right? Do you love the Lord this morning? Are you thankful? Are you grateful? God's a good God. Amen. Amen. Would you take a minute as our worship team gets ready? Would you take a minute and hug about two or three people's necks near you? Let them know it's good to see them in the house of the Lord. God bless you. Thank you for coming. We're going to worship together here in just a moment.
You cover me, you touch. strength to carry on. Oh, should have been the one to pay, but instead you took my place. Amazing grace, it's more than just a song. Even though I don't deserve all your love for me, you look beyond my faults and you showed me mercy. Here I am with all I have. I raise my hands to worship you. I want to say thank you. Oh, thank you. Say thank you. Oh, thank you for everything, for who you are. You cover me and touch my heart. I want to say thank you. Oh, thank you. I want to say thank you for the sun.
congregation sing that out. Every day we should be giving you thanks. You are worthy of all the praise, God. You have done so much for us, and we don't even understand. We don't even deserve it, God, how much you have done for us, the sacrifices that you've made, God. I just want to stop and tell you how much I love you and how much I praise you, God, because you're so worthy. God, when I was in a place that I didn't understand what was going on, I felt all alone. I felt like nothing was working out for me. You were there. And you've carried me this entire way in the palm of your hand, just like you've done for everyone in this place, God. We couldn't have been where we are without you. And I ask that you just help us this morning to remember where you've brought us from. To remember the blessings that you've given us, God. Even the simple things. I thank you that you woke me up this morning. I thank you that you gave me a chance to come into your house, God, and to spend time in your presence and to worship you. Even when it seems like life is crazy and there's no answers, God, help us to look to you and to give you thanks and to know that you are in control and that you are holding all the answers in your hand. Thank you, God. I exalt thee, oh Lord. raise your voices and sing that.
I exalt thee. I exalt thee. I exalt thee. Oh, Lord. I exalt thee. You're worthy. I exalt thee.
All the praise and all the honor. Holy God, to whom all praise is due, I stand in awe of you. I stand in awe of you. I stand.
Praise is due. I stand in
is devoted like a ring of solid gold, like a vow that is tested, like a covenant of old. Your love is enduring through the winter rain and beyond the horizons, with mercy for today, 'cause faithful you have been and faithful you will be. You pledge yourself to me, and that's why I sing. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Shoulder our weakness, and your strength becomes our own, and you're making me like you, clothing me in white, bringing beauty from ashes. For you will have your bride free of all her guilt and rid of all her shame, and known by her true name. That's why I sing. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. You will be praised, you will be praised. With angels and saints we sing, worthy are you, Lord. And you will be praised, you will be praised. With angels and saints we sing, worthy are you, Lord. You will be praised.
Praise the Lord. If you could take a moment, could you just give him praise? He's such a good God. Such a good God. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that's within me. Bless his holy name. Amen. Amen. God is so good. God is so good. You could be seated for a moment. Thank you for being in the Lord's house. It's good to see all of you in God's house. It's good to have my good friend Dave Fresina with us today. I appreciate him. Good to have you all with us today. Appreciate you coming to the Lord's house. Keep going. All right. I'm waiting on Christian. So we're going to do a song together, is entitled Thank You. And it's a newer song. It's probably not one you may or may not have heard, but we'll have the words on the screen so you'll be able to follow along. But, you know, I don't know. Sometimes I don't know how to put it in words, how good God's been to me. And, you know, when you think about it from this time of year and the perspective of what God's doing, and you think about where we're at in history and what's going on, and you just stop long enough to say, you know what, God, you've just been so good to me. And I don't even know how to say it. I don't know how to put it in words. I don't even know how to put it in perspective how good God's been. He's been good. Amen? Amen. He's worthy of praise. You ready now? All right, go ahead. How do I say thank you, Lord, for the way that you love and the way that you come, for all that you've done and all that you do? My heart pours out thank you. You don't have to come, but you always do. You show up in splendor and change the whole room. You don't have to come, but you always do. You show up in splendor and change the whole room. How do I say thank you, Lord, for the life that you gave and the cross that you bore, for the love you poured out to ransom my soul? My heart pours out this thankful song. You don't have to come, but you always do. You show up in splendor and change the whole room. You don't have to come, but you always do. You show up in splendor and change the whole room. How do I say thank you, Lord, for the life that you gave and the cross that you bore, for the love you poured out to ransom my soul? My heart pours out this thankful song. You don't have to come, but you always do. You show up in splendor and change the whole room. You don't have to come, you always do. You show up in splendor and change the whole room. You walked through all of my walls, conquered my shame, stepped into my past, filled my world with grace. You didn't have to come, but you wanted to. You walked through all of my walls, conquered my shame, stepped into my past, filled my world with grace. You didn't have to come, but you wanted to. You walked through all of my walls, conquered my shame, stepped into my past, filled my world with grace. You didn't have to come, but you wanted to. You walked through all of my walls, conquered my shame, stepped into my past, filled my world with grace. You didn't have to come, but you wanted to. You don't have to come, but you always do. You show up in splendor, change the whole room. You don't have to come, but you always do. You show up in splendor and change the whole room. How do I say thank you, Lord, for the life that you gave and the cross that you bore, for the love you poured out that ransomed my soul. My heart pours out this thankful song. You don't have to come, but you always do. You show up in splendor and change the whole room. You don't have to come, but you always do. You show up in splendor and change the whole room. You walked through all of my walls, conquered my shame, stepped into my past, filled my world with grace. You didn't have to come, but you wanted to. You walked through all of my walls, conquered my shame, stepped into my past, filled my world with grace. You didn't have to come, but you wanted to. You walked through all of my walls, conquered my shame, stepped into my past, filled my world with grace. You didn't have to come, but you wanted to. You don't have to come. Somebody praise him right now. But you always do. If you feel him in the rooms, talk to him right now. You show up in splendor and change the whole room. You don't have to come, but you always do. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You show up in splendor, change the whole room. Come on, give him praise. Hallelujah. God's a good God. Amen. Praise the Lord. I love it when he shows up, don't you? Amen. Our kids' church can be dismissed at this time. I'm thankful to know that God's in control. Amen. 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 Isaiah chapter 40, while they're being dismissed. Isaiah chapter 40. If you would stand for the reading of God's word, we're going to look at verses 25 through the end of the chapter at verse 31. I'm thankful to know today that God's in control. That no matter what I'm facing, no matter what I'm going through, God is in control. He's a sovereign God. Thankful for him today. Thankful that I get to be a part of his kingdom and a part of what he's doing. Thankful that God is sovereign over all my situations, that no matter what comes my way, he's such a good God. Amen? All right, don't get excited about it this morning, all right? All right. God's good. God's good. Isaiah chapter 40, beginning with verse 25. To whom then will you liken me? Or to whom shall I be equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see who has created these things, who brings out their host by number. He calls them all by name, by the greatness of his might and the strength of his power. Not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my just claim is passed over by my God? Have you not known? Have you heard, not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faints nor is weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, he increases strength. Even the youths shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Thank the Lord for his word today. Amen. Amen. A lot of times we get in circumstances. A lot of times we get in situations. We get in stuff. And we just wonder where the Lord's at. Why is God not coming through? Why is stuff not happening this? But I want to encourage somebody this morning and tell you, God's got this. God's got this. God's got this. It doesn't matter what it is today. It doesn't matter what's going on in your life today. God's got this. It could be health. It could be finances. It could be home. It could be job. It could be a lot of different things. But I want you to know this morning that God's got this. Amen. Tell your neighbor, God's got this. Come on, you got to help me preach this morning. Tell him, God's got this. God's got this. God's got this. Father, add your blessing to your word. Help me today to minister your gospel and to do what you've called me to do and to be effective. Father, I pray that your word will go forth today and not return void, but go forth and serve the purpose whereunto it was sent. And for all that's done and all that's accomplished, we'll be sure to give you the praise, the glory, the honor, and all these things. We'll ask it in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. You may be seated. One more time, would you remind your neighbor, God's got this. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God is so good. So I want to walk methodically through this portion of scripture that I brought to you this morning. I want to go verse by verse and just kind of expound a little bit if I can. This is what you call exegetical preaching. You're just kind of walking through the verses. And so we're going to kind of walk through it a little bit this morning and talk about these different things. But I'm praying today that somebody leave the house of God a little bit more encouraged to know that your situation that you're going through, God is very aware of what you're going through. I was, and I'll be honest with you, this was kind of inspired by a devotional that I read this week. And if you read the Our Daily Bread devotional, I believe it was yesterday's devotional that I was reading, and I just kind of got to thinking about this, and the Lord just began to talk to me about a little bit, this verse of scripture, and I'm just encouraged today to know that no matter what you're going through, what you're facing, God's got it. He's in control in his own time, and he knows what he's doing. So as I was reading this devotion, I got to thinking about the many times that I've, you know, and you've heard me say this, but a lot of times when I want to get alone with God, I go take walks, and I especially like to walk at nighttime when it's not as cold as it's been, but I like to walk at nighttime, and I really like to walk when it's not cloudy, and you can see all the stars, and you can see just the beauty of God's creation and what God has done, and you just look at it, and you just think to yourself, you know, if God was able to put all that in place, if God was able to put all this in perspective, if God was able to cause some of the things to happen in creation that we see happening, if God was able to do that, then surely God can handle my small little problem. If God is able to handle some of the situations that are going on in the world today and some of the things that we think are of such a great magnitude, then I've got to believe that God's got my situation, that God knows what my problem is, and that God is able, just at the speaking of the word, able to nullify the situation and bring me out and help me me to stand. God is such a good God. As a matter of fact, Isaiah begins this text with, to whom then will you liken me, or to whom shall I be equal, says the Holy One. Can I just stop here and tell you that nobody or no one compares to God? There's absolutely no one or nobody that is like Jehovah. There's nobody that is able to compare to whom God is. And so Isaiah, or God is asking Isaiah here, he says, listen, who are you going to liken me to, or who am I going to be equal to? There's nobody like me. I'm the one that created the heavens and the earth. I'm the one that flung the stars into the heavens. I'm the one that caused these mountains to be and these streams to flow and these oceans to be filled with water. I'm the one that did all this. Nobody can compare to the greatness of who I am. The Bible says, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. There is no God like Jehovah. I'm thankful today that I can call on his name. I'm thankful today that I have audience with the God Almighty. I'm thankful today to know that Jesus is the advocate for me for the Father. I'm thankful to know that no matter what I'm going through, I can call on the name of the Lord and I'm safe. I know that God is there with me and that God is going to see me through. I'm thankful today to know that God's got this. Amen. To whom then will you liken me, or to whom shall I be equal, says the Holy One? There's no one like the Lord. Do you believe that this morning? All right, somebody going to have to pinch your neighbor here in a minute. Wake them up. There's nobody like the Lord. Nobody's like him. The Bible says in Isaiah 40 and 26, he said, lift up your eyes on high and see who has created these things, who brings out their hosts by number. He calls them all by name, by the greatness of his might and the strength of his power. Not one is missing. Not one is missing. So here he says that he brings out their host by number. He's talking about the stars. In Psalm 147 and 4, he said he counts the number of the stars and he calls them all by name. Calls them all by name. God knows the stars. God knows every one of them. And the Bible said that not one of them is missing. Listen, our astrologists or our astronomers, they can look into the heavens and... And sometimes they say, well, there's this planet, or we found this star, or we found this. But God knew it was there all the time. There's been people that have been trying to search the universe and trying to find hidden secrets within the universe. But the Bible said that God knows every one of them by name. He put them in their place. He's the one that organized it and brought it all together. The Bible said that he counted the number of the stars, and he calls them all by name. In Isaiah 48 and 13, he said, indeed, my hand has laid the foundation of the earth, and my right hand is stretched out the heavens. When I call to them, they stand up together. The Bible said that even the heavens are under God's command. Even the heavens are under God's control. All God has to do is call out to the heavens, and the heavens stand at attention. The stars stand at attention. When he calls them by name, the host of heaven stands at attention to the call of God. Listen, friend, I just want you to be encouraged that even if the stars and the moon and the sun and the things that happen within the universe are at the beckoning call of God's command. Can I tell you that disease can still yield at God's command? Sickness can yield at the command of God. That no matter what your problem is in your home, God can still speak and those things can still... Listen, what manner of man is this that even the wind and waves obey him? Listen, he can still speak, peace be still, over your situation, and God can turn it around. All he has to do is speak the word. To speak the word. Listen, can I tell you that's the God that I serve? And that's exactly what we need. We need a word from the Lord. We need a word, an encouragement word from the Lord that God is saying to us, listen, I got this. I want you to know that no matter what you brought to the house of the Lord today, God is in control. Can you say amen? The heavens, the Bible says in Psalm 89 and 11, the heavens are yours. The earth also is yours. The world and all its fullness, you have founded them. David said in Psalm 8, 3 and 4, when I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained, what is man that you are mindful of him, and the son of man that you visit him? David in this psalm was saying, God, you know, with all the vastness of things that you have to tend to, all the greatness of the universe and all these things, God, what is man? I'm just a mere speck on the earthly stage, God. I'm nothing there, but God, why are you mindful of me? What is man that you're mindful, and the son of man that you would visit him? God, I'm not worthy to be visited. God, I'm not worthy that you should come and meet with me. God, I'm not worthy that you would come and spend time with me, but yet he still did. Listen, just like I just sang in that song, he didn't have to come, but he wanted to. He didn't have to do what he did, but he wanted to. He didn't have to send his son to die on a cross, but he wanted
wanted to. Listen, he loves you so much. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Listen, he didn't have to come, but he wanted to. I told you this many times. My daughters, when they were growing up and they would pray at night, there was a little thing that Kelsey used to say a lot. She says, Lord, I know you didn't have to do it, but I'm so glad you did it because you did it for me. Listen, she learned at a young age that the only reason she has existence, the only reason that she has the ability to be what she is and do what she does is because Jesus showed up. Can I tell you that on the day of Calvary, Jesus showed up. On the day of Pentecost, Jesus showed up. On the day of my salvation, Jesus showed up. When I was sick in my body, Jesus showed up. When my marriage was falling apart, Jesus showed up. When my kids were this and that and things like that, Jesus showed up. Can I tell you, that's all we need to know today. Is that Jesus showed up. He didn't have to. He didn't have to do it, but he loved us enough that Jesus would come to where we are. He said, Lord, when I consider the heavens, when I look at the moon and the stars, when I look at the vastness of the universe and you ordain these things, God, what am I? What am I, God, that you would consider my plight? What am I, God, that you would consider my circumstance, my situation? And God's just coming by to say to you today, I've got this. If I hung the stars and if I hung the moon and the sun, I've got your situation. It doesn't even compare to some of the stuff that I've had to deal with, but I'm still your Lord. I'm still your God, and I'm still able to see you through. Psalm 19:1, the Bible said, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament shows his handiwork. Anytime you get discouraged, just walk outside. Anytime you get down and out, just go walk outside. Walk out there today and look at the beauty of the orange and the reds and all the beauty of the leaves and look at what God created. If you get discouraged today, just walk outside and stand and bask in the heat of the sun. You say, well, the air is cold, but the sun is warm. Listen, you just get in the heat. Just walk outside tonight and look at the stars and the heaven and think to yourself, God, I can't even number them, but you know them all by name. When you get discouraged and you're down and out, just look at creation, look at the great things that God has done and be encouraged to know that if God was able to do all that, that God's able to work in your situation, that God is able to turn it. Listen, the heavens declare the glory of God. The heavens declare the glory of God. The heavens declare the glory of God. And we as the people of God ought to declare his glory. Creation. The Bible says in Romans chapter 8 that creation groans within itself. There's a longing within creation to be with God. They are a living testimony. And listen, they are doing exactly what they're created to do. When that water rushes over the rock down the waterfall and it makes that roaring noise, it's a praise and honor and glory to God because God created it for that purpose. When the trees rustle in the wind and the wind blows through the trees and the leaves rustle in those winds, listen, they're rendering praise unto God because they're doing what they were created to do. When the flowers bloom and they bring such beauty to the earth and we begin to see the majesty of the colors and all the different things, they're doing exactly what they were created to do. Listen, when the animals and I think about the birds of the air. When the birds of the air, they know what the seasons are and they fly to and fro to as the seasons go. Listen, they are created for that purpose and they are doing what they were created to do. Listen, they have no choice. They have to do what they're created to do. But we have a choice. And when we make that choice to do what we were created to do, and what were we created? We were created for the purpose of worship. We were created to magnify and honor the name of the Lord. We were created. And listen, when you do that, it brings glory and honor to the King. He said, the heavens declare the glory of God. The firmament shows his handiwork. Skip down to verse 28 of Isaiah 40. He says, have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faints nor is weary. His understanding is unsearchable. Think about that for a moment. When we're asleep at night, God's watching over us. When we're laying down in our bed at night, God is overseeing our problems and our circumstances. When we're sleeping through the troubles and the toils and all those things, God is still very aware of what's going on. Now, we just came through. We really didn't, but back home they came through Hurricane Matthew. But I remember when Hurricane Hugo came through.
My dad, you know, he was upset and worried about the family and which way this storm was going to go when Hugo came. And y'all saw a lot more chaos here than we did at home, didn't they, Tommy? We didn't really see as much there at home when we were. But you know, back in Dillon, you know, my dad, he was worried about the family. And so he sent us all to the uncle's house, which lived next door. And we all went over to Uncle Lynn's house and was hanging out there in the house. And the storm was coming and you could hear the wind howling. You know what I did? I went and found me a back bedroom, found me a bed and crawled up and went to sleep. Everybody was in the living room panicking and watching the news broadcast and which way the storm was going to go. I was just too ignorant to worry about it. Sometimes it's all right to be too ignorant to worry about it. You say, well, preacher, don't call us ignorant. Listen, that's not a demeaning term. Sometimes you just don't, you just want to trust God and His provision and know what God's got going on and say, Lord, I don't know it. My ways are not your ways. My thoughts are not your thoughts. God, I'm just too ignorant to worry about it. I don't know how I'm going to fix it. I don't know how I'm going to make it happen. So, God, I'm just going to trust that your understanding is unsearchable. I'm going to trust that you're neither faint nor are you weary. God, I'm going to trust that you've got my situation at hand and, God, you're going to work it out. God, I've sat down and I've fretted and I've worried and I became anxious. But God, I know that you're working for all things for my good. God, you're working it out for the purpose over my life. And I'm going to trust you with this, God. I'm going to believe, God, that you're going to work these things out. Look what David said in Psalm 90, verse 2. He said, for before the mountains were brought forth, or ever you had formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. The Bible says, in the beginning, God. Listen, that's all you need to know right there. That's good preaching right there. That's all you need to know. In the beginning, God. Before your problem formed, He was God. During your problem, He's God. And when He works your problem out, He's still going to be God. Glory to God. Can I tell you, David said, Lord, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. There is no God like you. David was a man of praise. He gave God his just due. He said, God, there is no God like you. You are God. When the enemies were trying to take me down, when people were trying to kill me, God, you're still God. When I didn't know where my next meal was coming from, I declared you to still be God. When the storms were beating down and the winds and waves were clapping, God, you're still God. David said, from everlasting, before the earth was even formed, before the mountains were even put in place, God, you are God. He said in Psalm 145 and 3, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised, and His greatness is unsearchable. In Psalm 147, He said, great is our Lord and mighty in power. His understanding is infinite. Listen, this is the God that we can trust. This is the God that we're calling on. This is the God that's got our situation. This is the God that's overseeing our problems. This is the God that said, I'm going to get you through this. Listen, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. Can I tell you today that no matter where you're at today, God is with you. God promised He'll never leave you nor forsake you, but will be with you even to the end of the earth. God is with you. Tell your neighbor, God is with you. See, God's got a purpose. God's got a plan. You don't understand why you're going through what you're going through. You may not understand, and I know I'm not preaching to the masses today. I'm probably talking to a handful of people. But you may not understand why you're going through what you're going through, but God's got purpose for it. God knows what He's doing. God's working these things out for you. The Bible said in Psalm 138 and 8, the Lord will perfect that which concerns me. Your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Do not forsake the works of your hands. He's saying, God, listen. You're working this thing for my life. God, you're making a way for me, God. You're pulling me through. God, you got purpose why you're doing what you're doing in my life. And God, through it all, your mercy is enduring forever. Your mercy, God's going to see me through. Your mercy's going to make a way for me. Your mercy's going to bring me through this trial. Your mercy's going to bring me through this struggle. And God, your mercy endures forever. My one plea to you, God, is do not forsake the works of your hands. God, it's your works. It's what you're doing in my life. God, don't leave me now. Anybody ever prayed that prayer? God, just don't leave me now. God, if I ever needed you, I need you now. God, if I ever been in a trial or struggle, God, I didn't know which way to turn or what, just don't leave me now, God. I can make it through this as long as I know you're with me. I can get through this problem, God, as long as I know you're right there with me. As long as you're directing my steps, God, I got confidence to know that, God, you're going to see me through. Paul had that kind of confidence. He said to the Philippian church, he said, being confident of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. Listen, God's working this work in you.
It doesn't always feel good. It's not comfortable. It's not something that's going to make you get up and shout every day. Sometimes you have to go through the struggle. Sometimes you have to go through the struggle. I'm going to go back to a comment I made a week ago. It was Tracy and I having this conversation. I couldn't remember who was having the conversation, but Tracy and I were having this conversation. That's bad when you can't remember a conversation you have with your wife. And she comes up to you after church, honey, you were talking to me. Okay, thank you. But Paul went to God three times. He said, Lord, can you remove this thorn in the flesh? Can you take me out of this situation? God, can you do, let me just put it in today's terms. God, can you some way, somehow get me through this mess? God, can you just go ahead and deliver me? Can you help me to get above the storm clouds? God, can you just elevate me and get me above the problem right now? God, could you just go ahead and supernaturally move in and just eradicate these issues, God, so that I can have clear sailing? God, can you do that for me? God, can you heal my marriage? God, can you heal my body, Lord? God, can you make my children act like they got some sense? Any parents ever prayed that one? Yeah. God, can you help my children act like they got some sense? And all the parents said, amen. You know, you pray those prayers, and you're asking God, and you're beckoning God, and you're saying to God, God, please, can you some way, somehow get me out of this? God said to Paul, Paul, I'm not bringing you out. I'm going to bring you through. Matter of fact, I'm going to leave it there. As a messenger of Satan, I'm going to leave it there to buffet you. I'm going to leave it there to keep you humble. I'm going to show you that even in the storm, I'm still God. You see, there's this false preaching out there today that if you're not delivered, if you're not out of the circumstance, if you're not in a situation, then you're not in God's will. Sometimes God's walking in the storm. Sometimes God shows up in the lion's den. Sometimes God shows up in the fiery furnace. Everybody else is saying, oh, they've lost out with God. Look at the troubles they're going through. You might not be, listen, it might not be that you're out of the will of God because you're in the trouble. It might be that you're in the middle of God's will because you're in the trouble. Because God has walked you into the trouble. And if God walked you into the trouble, then it's God is going to walk you through the trouble. And if God will walk you through the trouble, he's going to deliver you out of the trouble. All you got to do is trust him in the middle of the circumstance. To be like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Listen, King, we're not careful to answer you this matter, but our God is able to deliver us. And if he doesn't, we're still not going to worship this false God. Listen, that's the mindset you got to have. God, no matter what I'm going through, I'm still going to trust you as God. No matter what the doctors say, I'm still going to trust you as God. No matter what the checkbook looks like, God, I'm still going to trust you as God. No matter what my body feels like, God, I'm still going to lift my hands and praise you and magnify you because I know, God, you've got this. You've got this. Paul said, being confident of this thing. And that's the thing you got to have. You got to have confidence to know that God is still there. Listen to me, somebody. God wants to shake your confidence. The enemy wants to shake your confidence, rather. The enemy wants to shake your confidence in God. The enemy wants to come against you and make you disbelieve. He wants to make you doubt. He wants to get you frustrated. He wants to get you all in turmoil. I'm sure, Sister Elizabeth, dealing with the pain in your jaw, there were times you said, God, are you even concerned about what's going on inside of me? God, are you even aware of what's happening right now? I'm sure in circumstances and situations, I'm not going to try to get too personal here, but I'm sure there's been times in the midst of the trial, you're saying, God, are you even there? God, where are you at? And the enemy just comes along and says, see, God left you there. See, you're all alone. God's not going to fix this problem. This thing's going to kill you. This thing's going to take you down. You're going to lose everything you got. That's what the enemy wants you to believe. But Paul said, be in confidence of this very thing. If God began it, God's going to finish it. Listen, that's the mindset you got to remind the devil. When you don't feel like anybody's around, you better remind yourself of the promises of God and say, God, you said you'd never leave me nor forsake me. Even though I don't feel you, I know you're still here. Even though I don't sense your presence, God, I still declare by your word because you are not man that you should lie. But God, I'm going to declare your promises. God, you promised me that you'd be with me, and I declare that your presence is here with me right now. Even though I don't feel it, even though I feel like throwing in a towel and quitting, God, I'm still going to declare you as God over my situation. You got to be confident that God that began it is the God that will complete it. Isaiah 40 Verse 29, he said he gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, he increases strength. God, I don't know if I can take this any longer. The Bible said in our weakness, his strength is perfected. It's in that moment when you can't put one foot in front of the other, God says, I'll come in and help you. It's in that moment when you feel like throwing in the towel and quitting, God says, I've got you. I'll bury you for a little while. It's in that moment when you feel like, man, I just can't. There's no more hope for this city. There's no more strength. God, I'm drained. I'm completely drained. I don't know what else to do. It's in that moment that God says, come on, I've got you. I'll carry you a little while longer. I'll help you through this. I can make a way for you. Listen, I can make streams in the desert flow. I can do things in your life that you didn't think were possible. If you'll just look to me, I've got this. I've got your hand. I've got your life. All you got to do is trust him. He gives power to the weak. And those who have no might, he increases strength. Look what Paul said to the Corinthian church, 2 Corinthians 4:16. He said, therefore, if we do not lose heart, even though our outward man is perishing, yet the inward man is being renewed day by day. You know what Paul said to the world? I look like I'm about down and out. To the world, it looks like I'm crushed. To the world, it looks like I'm never going to make it. To the world, they're looking at me on my outward appearance and they're saying, boy, that guy looks terrible. That guy looks tired. That guy looks worn out. That guy looks like he's about to die. That guy, but God said, listen, even though the outward man is perishing, the inward man is being renewed day by day. My friend Ray, most of you know, about 4 months ago, his wife Terry passed away, and I went to see her before she slipped into that coma-like state that a lot of cancer folks, when they're dying, they slip into. And I walked into the room, and she didn't even turn her head. She just heard my voice, and I heard her say, Joy Dog's here. And she just had the biggest smile on her face. And to look at her, listen, to look at her as a cancer patient, to look at her, you could just tell that cancer was having its way. It was eating at her body, eating at her muscular system. I mean, she was practically down to nothing. This lady that was healthy and strong and weighed like the 130s. Now she's down to like 90 pounds. She's just weak and frail and nothing but skeletal. But on the inside, she never lost her confidence. On the inside, she said, God's still my God, and God's going to see me through. And if I go through on this side, that'll be great. But if I see him on the other side, that's going to be even greater. Listen, friend, even though the outward man is perishing, yet our inward man can be renewed day by day. No matter what you're facing, no matter what things are weighing on you or what things are pressing against you, he said, keep on keeping on, because God is going to refresh that inward man in your life. Psalm 29:11. The Bible said the Lord will give strength to his people. The Lord will bless his people with peace. This word peace, and you've heard me say this many times, but this word peace literally means the peace that passes all understanding. It just means a peace that just doesn't make sense. You know, you're able to smile in the midst of the circumstances. You know, Sister Helen walked in this morning, and she come across, and she's been sick, and they're running tests, and they're trying to check this out and out, all this other stuff out in her body, and they're looking at all the physical things that she's dealing with. And I said, how you doing, sister? She said, I feel great. You know why she said, I feel great? Because she followed up. She said, I feel great because I'm in the Lord. Listen, that's what it makes sometimes. Listen, your body might be weak and things might be attacking you physically, but you're able to say, you know what? I've got peace because I know who my God is. I know in whom I believe, and I am persuaded that my God is able to keep me. No matter what looks like on the outside, God is renewing me, and he's giving me strength, and he's giving me peace. The kind of peace that just doesn't make sense. The kind of peace that looks at a situation and with a smile on your face and say, it's going to be okay. When everybody else is pulling their hair out. When everybody else is saying, this is the end. When everybody else is saying, oh boy, I don't know how we're going to make it here. That peace that rises up in the side of you and says, it's going to be all right. Because God's giving me assurance. God's giving me peace. God's let me know it's going to be all right. God's a good God. Listen, he'll bless his people with peace. Look what Isaiah says, Isaiah 41:10. God is encouraging us here. He said, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Listen, God's got this. God's got this, and he's going to see you through. All you got to do is trust him. He's going to make a way. Because if you come on, in Isaiah 40, verses 30 and 31, he said, even that the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Listen, God's got this. Psalmist David said in Psalm 34 and 10, he said, the young lions lack and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. That's good news right there. No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're facing, God said, I've got it for you. I'm going to take care of it for you. No matter what you're facing, no matter what you're going through, he said, you shall not lack any good thing. The Bible said, no good thing shall he withhold from them that walk uprightly before him. God wants to bless you with good things. God wants to take care of you. And listen, he said in verse 30, he said, even if youths fail, even if the youths faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall, even though they go through this, if you'll just wait on the Lord, if you'll just wait on the Lord, God said, I'll renew your strength. If you'll just wait on the Lord, I'll cause you to mount up on wings like eagles. You can run and not be weary. You can walk and not faint. God's a good God. Look what he said in Galatians 6 and 9. He said, let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. Listen, that's what the enemy wants to strip away from you. He wants to take your belief. He wants to take you. He wants to take your faith. He wants to strip it and cause you to lose heart. And God said, listen, even in the midst of the trial, don't lose heart. I'm with you. I'm with you. He's saying to you today, I've got this. And you might say, well, preacher, somebody must be really suffering a big old problem here today. Listen, it could be the smallest of things, but God still got it. You could have walked in this building today with the slightest of worries, but God's still concerned. The Bible said, consider the lilies, how they spin and toil. And Solomon, all of his glory, went arrayed like one of these. If God Almighty put so much confidence and so much distinction on even the lilies, even the sparrows, how much more is he concerned about you? God's got this. God's got this. He said, consider him in Hebrews 12 and 3. For consider him who endured such hostility from sinners against himself, lest you become weary and discouraged in your souls. Listen, when you're down and out and you get depressed and it seems like, man, you can't make a way. Listen, he said, consider him. Consider Jesus. Stop for a minute and remember what Jesus went through for you. Stop for a minute and remember how good God has been to you through Jesus. Stop for a minute and remember that you're not on your way to hell, but you're on your way to heaven because of Jesus. Consider him who endured such hostility from sinners against himself. Jesus didn't deserve what he went through. He didn't have to go through what he did. But we have not a high priest which cannot be touched by the feelings of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. The Bible said that Jesus went through what he went through for you. He was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. The government was on his shoulders, and by his stripes we're healed. Listen, consider him. When you don't think you can take it another day, consider Jesus. Stop long enough and get your mind off your problem and get your mind on Jesus and begin to magnify him and watch the problem begin to decrease as God begins to increase in your life. Unanswered questions. Unanswered questions. Problems without any solutions. Things that are going on in your life that you don't feel like can be turned around, those are things that my God specializes in. When doctors say no, God can still say yes. When the world says no way and it's impossible, God says it's possible. That's the God that I say. Don't be discouraged in your soul. Don't you get weary while doing good. Keep on doing what you're doing. Keep on keeping on, as the old folks used to say. Keep on pressing on to that mark of the prize of the high calling of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Don't give up now. Don't give in. Don't you throw in the towel. You've come too far to turn around now. God's been too good to you to stop now. Don't give up. Consider Jesus today and know that he went through what he went through so that you could walk in victory. He's a good God. He's a good God. I want to read 2 Corinthians chapter 4, the entire chapter. It's 18 verses, and we're going to conclude with this chapter right here. Let this word speak to you right now.
He said, therefore, since we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we do not lose heart. But we have renounced the hidden things of shame, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. But even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing, whose minds the God of this age is blinded, who do not believe, lest the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine on them. For we do not preach ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your bondservants for Jesus' sake. For it is the God who commanded light to shine out of darkness, who has shown in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellence of the power may be of God and not of us. We are hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Always carrying about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our body. For we who live are always delivered to death for Jesus' sake, that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our mortal flesh. So then death is working us, but life in you. And since we have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, I believed and therefore I spoke. We also believe and therefore speak, knowing that he who raised up the Lord Jesus will also raise us up with Jesus and will present us with you. For all things are for your sakes, that grace, having spread through the many, may cause thanksgiving to abound to the glory of God. Therefore, we do not lose heart. Even though our outward man is perishing, yet the inward man is being renewed day by day. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, is working for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. While we do not look at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporary, but the things which are not seen are eternal. Hear the word of the Lord today. God is saying what you're going through right now, what you're facing right now, he's got it. And it's only a temporary thing. It's not anything that's going to kill you. It's actually something that's going to build you up and make you stronger. It's not anything that's going to destroy you. But he said, in this, I'm going to take this thing and it's going to work for you an exceeding weight of glory. That's what God wants you walking in. He wants you walking in the glory. He wants you walking in the power of God. He wants you to understand that even though the enemy may come and press on you and crush on you and try to stop you, you will not be destroyed. He said, don't you be disheartened and don't you be dismayed, for I am with you and I'm going to see you through. Just trust me. Trust me. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Father, in the name of Jesus, I've delivered the word that you told me to deliver, and there's folks here this morning, if they'll be honest, they're discouraged. They're wondering. They got a lot of questions, but they're not getting a lot of answers. They don't know which way to turn or what to do. They don't know what to do. I see some, even this week, God, in prayer, that have thrown up their hands and said, you know what? I can't take no more, God. I don't know what else to do. But Lord, you've sent this word today to encourage somebody to tell them, listen, I've got this. I've got this. Lord, I don't know how much more I can endure. I don't know how much more I can take. But God, you said you've got it. That's going to be my confidence, to know that you've got it. You're such a good God. We praise you today. We praise you today. Before I call you to this altar, I want to share one more thing with you. You've heard this many times, but look at me for just a moment. I told you when my wife was diagnosed with cancer, me and God, we had a one-on-one. Tracy and I even talked about this last night. She said, oh, that wasn't that big of a deal. You know, breast cancer, ain't that big of a deal. God's got it. That's easy to say on this end side of it. You know, when the tests come back and everything's good and everything's clear. But when the doctor's sitting in a room and he's looking at you saying, this is aggressive. We got to get this quickly. We got to move now. We can't wait on this. Listen, I'm a man of faith. I believe God. I know God's got things. But I'm going to tell you something. My world shook upside down in that moment. I drove Tracy home. I put her, I said, I got to go. I'll be back in a little bit. And I took a ride, and I started arguing with God about the best way I could put it. I said, Lord, you can't take my wife from me. I can't, God, we can't have this. And in that prayer time, God spoke and said, I'm in control and I've got this. Let me tell you something, folks. There's a peace that came over me. And I've told you, I'd go to pray and I wouldn't even pray about cancer because God had already assured me he got it. And you say, well, you probably should have asked him about it. Why? He already told me he had it. Why have I got to ask him about something he's already gave me assurance that he's got? Why have I got to go argue with God anymore? He already said, listen, I got this. I put my confidence there. I put my confidence in the peace that I felt to know that God was in control and that God was going to make a way. And I'm telling you that God wants to give somebody that same assurance today. God wants somebody in this room today to leave with a confidence that you don't have to fret, you don't have to worry, you don't have to be discouraged, you don't have to leave this place in despair. You can leave with a peace that passes all understanding to say, God, I know you see where I'm at. I know you see what I'm going through. And God, I just want to tell you I trust you. And God's going to let you know that he's going to give you the assurance to know that he's going to see you through. So I want to ask you today, it could be very small and you might say, well, it's not that big of a deal. And you can say that if you want to, but God's aware of it. Or you can have something of a grand magnitude that has rocked your world and you're sitting here today in such discouragement because you don't know what else to do. And God says, I'm aware of it. I've got it. So I want to ask you today, from the smallest of what you think is issues to the grandest of problems and situations, if you've got something that you need God to give you peace over today, I want you to come from where you are and just come and stand right across this altar and let God begin to give you peace. Is there somebody here that say, Pastor, it's me. I got stuff going on in my life. I got things and issues that I'm dealing with. I got a lot of questions and I've not gotten the answers yet. Is there anybody else that I joined Stephanie and said, that's me, God. I need some answers. I need some peace. I need some strength. I need some encouragement. Is there anybody else that said, that's me, Lord. Anybody else willing to join Stephanie and Dell and say, God, that's me. I'm fighting with some things. I've got some questions. I don't know what to do or which way to turn. God, I've got a lot of things that are coming against me right now. God, I need your help. I need your help. They're still coming, so I'm going to wait just a moment. Anybody else want to join Noah or Stephanie and Dell? Anybody else want to say, that's me, Pastor? I'm dealing with some stuff, and I need God to answer my questions. I wait. I know maybe some of you are wrestling with, oh, what are they going to think about me? What are they going to say if they see me up there? What's that matter? If you can leave this place with peace today, what's that matter? Listen, God can give you peace over worrying about what other people are going to say. Listen, he did me. I don't care what people think about me. I don't care what people say about me. God, give me peace. The only opinion that matters is what God says. Don't worry about it. God's got it. One more moment. Anybody else? Say, Pastor, that's me. That's me. Listen, God's got your answer. Let me clarify that. God is your answer. God is your answer. God's aware. Trace, can you bring up the Isaiah 41:10 scripture one more time, please? Listen, I want you to be encouraged. Everyone that's in this altar, I want you to look toward the screen. Look toward the screen for just a moment. He said, fear not. For I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you, and I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Can we just stop right there and say, God, I thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for being my strength. Thank you for helping me through my problem. Thank you, Lord, for being with me. God's a good God. He's a good God. And all he wants to do is give you strength. All he wants to do is give you courage. You can face the problem. You can face tomorrow. God's with you. So, folks, I'm just going to assume that the rest of you, everything's good. All right? For right now. But there's been moments that you said, you know what, Pastor, you give this article 2 weeks ago or 2 months ago or a year ago, I'd have had to walk down that aisle. I'd have had to come down there, but God brought me through. If that's you, and you believe that God is able to help them through whatever they're facing, I want you to come and get in behind them when we're going to pray for them. That God's going to touch them and God's going to help them. God's going to make a way for them. God's a healer. God's a deliverer. God's a way maker. And I know God's able. Come on, folks. Come on. Come on. You know God's brought you through. We're going to believe God's going to do it for these. Father, in the name of Jesus, come on, begin to intercede with them. Begin to believe that God's going to touch them. Believe that God's going to help them. Believe that God's going to make a way. Believe that God's going to make a way. You good? Got something? Come on, let's do it. Come on, intercede, folks. Come on, begin to believe with them. Believe for them. Come on, stand in their stead. Believe that God's going to make a way for them. Believe God's going to turn it around. Wait a minute. Believe God's going to turn it around. Believe God's going to turn it around.
So through it all, my eyes are on you. Through it all, it is well. Through it all, my eyes are on you, and it is well. In front of me will be thrown into the midst of the sea. And through it all, my eyes are on you. Through it all, it is well. In front of me will be thrown into the midst of the sea. And through it all, my eyes are on you. Through it all, it is well.
And trust in him, the ways in
soul and trust in Him. The ways and when still know His name. So let go, my soul, and trust in Him. The waves and wind still know His name. The waves and wind still know His name. His way.
Mistake my worship for something that causes me to be down, but I'm well. Everything's all right. It is well.
It is well. With my soul.
Come on, it's well. Worship Him. Hallelujah. You got my circumstance. You got this. You're faithful. You're faithful. You're faithful, Jesus. Hallelujah. It's well. It's well. Hallelujah.
It is well.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus.
With my soul.
Hallelujah, God. I declare today. Okay.
It is well. It is well.
Come to tell somebody, weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. Days of weeping are almost over. Days of dark clouds, He's about to blow them back. The winds and waves can't touch you any longer. God's going to speak peace. Be still, and they're going to lay down. He's a good God. Trust Him today. Trust Him today. My little sister, you blessed me today. Just when you walked in the door, I knew God had His hand on your life. Father, I ask you right now, speak peace. You're such a good God. If you believe that today, come on and give God praise in his house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, bless the King. Bless the King in his house today. He's worthy of praise. He's worthy of praise. He's worthy of praise. He's worthy of praise. Sing it one more time, Kelsey. It is well.
It is well.
Come on, make it a song. Make it a prayer.
With my soul.
It is well. Come on, sing it, Kelsey.
It is well.
It's all right. God's got this. It's all right. God's got this. God's got this. Thank you, Lord.
It is well.
Hallelujah.
With my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul.
It is well.
It is well.
Thank you, Jesus.
With my soul.
Peace like a river, God.
It is well.
Say peace like a river. Flood their hearts, their souls today,
with
Jesus.
With my soul.
We look to you, Jesus. We confess today that you've got this.
It is well.
We confess today, Lord, our total surrender to you.
With my soul.
And with this, God, we declare it is well.
It is
you've got this, God.
Well.
Father, I pray that they walk out of this building with confidence today. Confidence to know that you are well aware of where they are and what they're going through. You're well aware of the circumstance and the situation. And I pray that when they walk out of this door, that they do not walk out in fear or despair or discouragement, but having their hearts flooded with peace. To know that some way, somehow, you're going to make a way. For every person that came to this altar, God, you may not deliver them out. You may walk them through, but even in that, help them to have the confidence to know that you that begun a good work shall complete it against the day of Jesus Christ. We will not fear. We will not be dismayed. For you, God, of the Holy One of Israel. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Lamb of God. You're such a good God. Just take a moment and love on the Lord. Come on, just love on him. Let God speak to you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The Spirit of God had already spoke to me to speak this verse, but I believe it's in order. He said, but now thus says the Lord who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name, and you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flames scorch you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I gave Egypt for your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in your place. Since you were precious in my sight, you have been honored, and I have loved you. Therefore, I will give men for you and people for your life. Fear not, for I am with you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for always being with us, Lord. Thank you for always seeing us through. Thank you for keeping us, God. You're such a good God. No matter what the waters rage or no matter what fires burn, God, you protect us. You protect us. You're such a good God. We bless your name today. We give you glory. We give you honor. You are worthy of praise. Worthy of praise. Worthy of praise. Do you love the Lord? Come on, aren't you thankful? God's a good God. I want us to join together and pray one last prayer together before we be dismissed. And this is what I want us to pray together. I want us to pray for rain in this area. Pray for rain for those in the mountain area. Michael's up working in the mountain area up there, and he said there's 9 different fires burning. And if they touch the area that they're working in, he's going to be totally encircled by that fire. We need rain. And listen, I believe that God can send a cloud the size of a man's hand, and it'd be an abundance of rain. And some people might say, well, be careful what you ask for. Right now, I'd be all right with whatever God wants to give me. A sprinkle or a flood. Well, let's don't say flood. A sprinkle or a nice downpour. How's that sound? But I want us to pray for rain as we get ready to close and go home. Pray God would send the rain that we need, that God would send the rain to these territories. Because I want to tell you something, what was happening yesterday and what's been happening early this morning with the dry conditions and the winds, that does not help fires at all. And it's very dangerous. It's very dangerous for those that are trying to put these fires out. The last I heard, they were only 15% contained. 15% contained. This is a very dangerous situation. People are having to be evacuated. Kelsey is at school, and she's up in that mountainous area, and her campus is just inundated with that smoke. She's got classmates that are having asthma attacks as a result of this smoke. It's a very dangerous situation. It's not just the fires. It's the smoke. It's the air quality. It's a lot of things that affect a lot of different people. It's probably why I've not gotten over this mess yet, because just the air quality. It's just very dangerous. So I want us to join together and agree. And the Bible said that if we agree, it's touching any one thing, whatever we agree on, whatever we bind to be bound, whatever we loose to be loosed. I want God to loose the heavens and let us get the rain that we need to be able to do what needs to be done, to be able to not only just put out these fires, but give us the water we need here in this area. It's a very, very dry where we're at right now. And so we want God to do that. Amen. You agree with me on that? Amen. Would you stand as we get ready to close in prayer, and would you join with someone near you? Make a friend. If you don't know somebody, introduce yourself. Tell them it's good to see them in God's house. You just don't want to go holding strangers' hands. But some people don't mind. But let's agree together and ask God to have his way, and that God would send rain, and that God would just pour out his blessing on this community in this area. And we'll believe God for it today. Listen, the weatherman, they say 20% here, 10% there. But God can take what man says 10 or 20 and make it 100. Amen? Amen. So let's pray in agreement together. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for the reminder of that there are times that we have problems and circumstances, God, and you've got those. Well, God, we come to you with another issue. This area needs rain. God, this whole end of the state needs rain. And God, we're just believing and trusting, Lord, that you can send the rain. You can send the waters. You can send those things that are needed. And God, we just believe and trust for your will to be done. God, I just believe that you can send it in a way that it'll be beneficial. God, I know that right now, as dry as it is, that if it came all at one time, it would just run off and cause flash floods and more damage. But God, that's not what we're asking for. We're just asking for slow and steady rain, God, that can just penetrate the earth and put these fires out and just wash the air and give the air quality what it needs. And God, we as a body of believers right now ask you for that, Lord, that you would just begin to do that, God, and that you would begin to move and manifest your glory, your presence in a way that only you can, God. I know that there are other churches in this area. I've seen it on their signs. I know that it's on the heart of a lot of people. God, we need the rain. And I just pray, God, that your will be done in that, God, that you would send the rain. Send the rain, Jesus. Send the rain and let it be for your glory, God. We'll give you the praise for it. We'll give you the glory for it, God. We bless your name, Jesus. Thank you for this day. Thank you for reminding us, God, that you've got our problems. You've got our circumstances, God. You're in control. And we don't have to be weary and doing good. God, we don't have to be inundated with despair or fear or doubts. But God, we can put our full trust and confidence in you, even when it doesn't look like it by what we see. God, we look to those things that are not seen, because the things we see are temporary, but the things that are not seen are eternal. And so, God, we put our confidence and our faith in that. We thank you for that, Jesus. Thank you for this day. Thank you for this opportunity. Be with us throughout the remainder of this afternoon, God, and bring us back together tonight to worship and to praise you. Be with those, our young people in the service they're going to. Bless those that are serving our less fortunate here in the community, our seniors, God, as they're serving those. I pray, God, that you would help them and anoint them and use them, God, and let them be a witness to those that are at the Christian ministries. God, use everything that's done this day. Be done for your glory and your kingdom, and we'll give you the glory, the honor, the praise for it. We ask it all in Jesus' name, and everybody said, amen. Hug that neck, shake that hand, that person next to you, and tell them it's good to see them in God's house. God bless you.